November 20, 1851, and in the Theater of Lima, a play is staged in support of the armed forces and the dedicated police force they want for their great nation of Peru, Bolivia. Hello everyone, I call myself Zondagskind, and I like to play Victoria 3. And yeah, we got the popular popular playwright endorses reform again. So, I suppose I want to make them even better, even more stronger. Although, again, the prestige is like, I'm addicted to it, man. Let's take the prestige. Yeah. Also, we got maximum relations with Hawaii. So what can we do with those maximum relations? We can form an alliance, form a defensive pact. I mean, I guess a defensive pact. How much military do you have? You have one conscript battalion. So I would basically be, militarily protecting you, which does not sound great. So I don't like the idea of a defensive pact. What would it take to get you into my customs union? It's not adjacent to ours. I beg to disagree. I mean, how would I border your market? Like, would you consider Mexico to border your market? Would it depend on, like, my supply network? I don't know, man. Maybe if I had these islands, which are as close to Hawaii as can be. What else? Oh, wait, but you're on the cusp of getting a trade agreement. So, is there anything at all, I could trade with Hawaii? Tools. So you're getting tools but not using them. Seems like a great deal. Nicely done, Hawaii. You're making meat, making tea, fruit, fish. Fish, if I remember correctly, was expensive in our market. Fish is expensive. So let's import fish from the Hawaiians. Where is it? Hawaii. 20 fish. Yes, thank you. And that means you should be amenable to a trade agreement. Yes, yes. Don't even need to owe an obligation. And then I suppose, I'm not sure if we're ever going to get into the customs union. Genial, amicable. Yeah. It's just, not sure if that's ever going to happen, because I could look like OMA obligation. That's only 30. Yeah. So I don't think that's happening. I don't think Alliance and Defense Pact alter that modifier. But let's unpause the game again, because we wanted to get to railroads. I do want to get to railroads now in this episode. That's my goal. Canned food for food industries. That's nothing we can do yet. See, I really want now to get to railroads. Services are expensive. Really expensive. So we really need more urban centers, I suppose. Or we really need to get to glass or get more coal and then use that for our urban centers. Urban. Like, what can I do? I don't have any glass, so that's a problem. I don't have enough coal at all. Although, yeah, no, yeah. Thing is, I would need way more coal to really fix it. I'm taxing it, which is making me a nice revenue at the moment. Tricky. Also, at some point, I want to lower the taxes again, but as you can see, we're running a very, very tight budget again. Also, our former president, Bernardo Blanco, has retired and immediately died. That's the way it works in this game. They retire and immediately die. Retire, man, it's dangerous. Anyway, arming the natives. Bring it on, Ecuador! National effort to implement dedicated police force has become the subject of debate between partisan newspapers. Okay. So we can either let this newspaper say what they want, which gives us a small benefit. We can issue our own editorials, which has a small chance of big success, large chance of small failure. And papers have spoken freely enough on this matter. Large chance of big success. Why would you ever choose this one over that one? I don't understand. Like, what? Why would you even give these two as an option, since this one is strictly better? Like, unless you specifically don't want to enact it, then I suppose you could try this. Honestly, on one hand, I'll do this. Yeah. Gold fields depleted in Peruvian-Bolivian Araucania. That is unfortunate. But it does mean that you can now get my favorite building, the gold mine. Do you already have any market access? No. So you do desperately need the port. And I do want to finish the tooling workshop before that. Okay, so that's fine. Okay. Slowly losing money now. I'm not too fussed about it, I suppose. Tooling workshop. Coming in here. Oh, I'm subsidizing you. Why? I'm not sure why I'm subsidizing some of these buildings. Subsidizing tooling workshops. Okay. 80 more iron. Nope, I'm already short on iron. But I suppose you are profitable, so I don't need to subsidize you. Oof. That frees up a lot of money. Because it's money that they're losing. Why, though? Should be demand for tools. There'll be more demand for tools in the coming weeks, so I think it's fine. Conceptual battalions, and we still have military. We also have production technology cost reduced, so let's see. Food industries, we don't have. Sewing machines. Mechanized looms. Nope. Bone china, paper bleaching. Man, like I said, we're kind of out-sciencing our production. Which is weird. So I suppose we just go for a society tech. Like central banking. Which were really good for us. So after this, I do want to try and get the intelligentsia happier. Since once they do get happy, we'll get a lot of benefit there. So, well, there's a couple of things they could really do. We can't do that. We could do that, but the armed forces oppose this, and I wanted to do, like, armed forces Lollapalooza. We could do propertied women by bringing the intelligentsia in. Okay. Unproductive trade routes. Yeah, I suppose. Although I'm kind of surprised by that, since coal should be fairly expensive still. No? Okay. Yeah, okay. Then we can at least get rid of one of them. Boop! Then the other one should be about productive? No? Still unproductive? Okay, get lost. Then you should be... Oh, looking in Ecuador. That makes a lot of sense. That doesn't work. Yeah, you just need more people. And then we actually need to spend the coal on something. What? You could do 80 coal. So we need something to use 40 coal in. I can do that. Yeah, I can do that by making mines, which do that. Also, we kind of needed to use more tools because our tool manufactory wasn't profitable. So, butchering tools, yes, please. And I suppose this would actually be overkill. So we go to this one. Oh, we go to the one in La Paz. And set that one to atmospheric pumping. Yeah, making a lot more money. Very nice. And we should not have shortages anywhere. Doesn't seem like it. Nope. Nope, still doing okay. Still doing okay. The rally run roughshod. What? A largely peaceful demonstration for preserve no police has been violently broken up by the local militia. The rural folk, a major supporter of the movement, is particularly upset by the violence. This incident has led many to question the wisdom in establishing any permanent law enforcement with the right to use force. Blah, 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 blah. Pronunciation. Nope. Ooh. Yeah, I mean, I would actually agree with this. Like we want a dedicated police force exactly so we can be more professional and not have, like, these militia, these butchers running around. So, this does have a really bad success chance, but let's do it anyway. Yeah, that was bound to happen. Why do we have a stall? Oh, yeah, that's because of the movement. Yeah. That's fine. Well, it's not really fine, but I'll have to deal with it. So, building the gold mine in Araucania. Amazing. Yes. The port doesn't have enough people. But we'll deal with it. Hey! More influence, less bureaucracy used on my people. I think that means we have some bureaucracy to spare. Oh, bureaucracy is getting... It's getting more expensive per level. But we can incorporate, like, one state. Yeah. Let's incorporate Tonga. That seems good. And an election is coming up again. Seems like the Patriotic Party is doing very well again. Good on you guys. The gold mine is ready. Can't see it, but it's somewhere. We promise it's there. Really. Against the odds. Despite not... Oh yeah, we have an event again where we can be nicer to Quechua people. Or we cannot. I suppose... You're still... Oh, you're very loyal. Yeah. I can take this hit. Still, very happy petite bourgeoisie, which is helping the loan interest stay low. And we are making good money. And now we're working on our steel mill. It'd be amazing. Yeah. You can do this. Let's try and get you profitable. Then I'll... Are you low? Yeah, you're low on axes, so then you need the port. Then you get the motor industries. You'll be slightly over your axis, but I can't build you a port. I believe this is the Titicaca Lake, which I believe is where the Bolivian Navy in real life still holds their what'd you call it? Or is this the? I don't know, man. But there's a lake. Bolivia doesn't have a coastline anymore, so it does its naval stuff in a lake, basically. Okay, I have no infamy. I'm not using my diplomacy. That is bad. Whoop, 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 whoop. I still like that Hawaii wants to be your friend. Oh, now Chile wants to be in an alliance as well. Yeah, let's do that. Oh, and no, they would not accept. But Chile would accept. Sure. I mean, you do have an army, so at least for you it makes sense. Of course, nobody wants to be our protectorate. Why would they? Great Britain would allow us into their customs union, but let's not do that. Let's try and be independent. We'll also get a trade agreement with Chile? Sure. And with New Granada? Sure. Does anyone want to join our customs union? No. Nope. That's fine. Well, hey, we can get more trade with these guys without the cost of bureaucracy. Improve with the US, sure. And with Portugal and Russia? Actually, let's start to damage relations with Argentina, because maybe Brazil won't come to their aid. It'd actually be pretty funny if Brazil came to the aid of Argentina in a war. Although I suppose historically that did happen in a war against Paraguay. Or at least they attacked the same. They were on the same side of that war, but probably to their own discontent. Yeah, market access is bad. We know that. Not exactly getting better either. Didn't really need that port. Free government reform. It is October 29, 1853, and José Bayivian is still our president. I believe the next thing we wanted to do is get the intelligentsia in. Get in on this action, man. Booyah. Let's try to get dedicated police force and then get that reform we wanted. So how is our institution? 31, so we could incorporate one more state. Incorporate... I suppose we do incorporate Tahiti specifically. Yep. Like maybe, like sure there is an advantage to keeping it unincorporated because, well we're not really. Oh, hey, we have a police force. Very nice. So we will have fewer radicals and less of a penalty from turmoil, which is good. That's very nice. So now I wanted to do something the intelligentsia like because we're working on central banking. So let's see. Didn't want to do wealth voting. Did I want to do propertied women? We'll radicalize the church. But am I fine with that? You're giving me investment pool and influence. Want right of assembly? No. Total separation. Catholic Church doesn't like that. Really doesn't like that. Like, they get angry. I could... This would endanger my loyalty from the petite bourgeoisie. I suppose the best one here is propertied women. So, basically, right now, we have legal guardianship. Our women are under the guardianship of men, either their fathers or their husbands, or maybe even their brothers. And now we will have propertied women. Even women have the right and duty to own and cherish their possessions. So it's not that they are property of men, it's that they have property of their own. Yeah, so let's placate the intelligentsia by doing that. It does mean we get lower education access, which is not great. And we're losing some of the benefits we had with the landowners. But we do now have cheaper technology in the society tree. So that's good. Okay, so the steel mill is ready. We need to subsidize that. Because so far we have no use for steel. We could maybe... see if we can export it for now. Yeah, we can export it to the... I would rather not use bureaucracy there. So I suppose... Yeah, I suppose we can sell it to the New Grenadines and to... Hawaiians and the Chileans. All people we have trade agreements with. True. Defensive pact with New Granada. Yeah, sure. Sure. That's fine. Okay, so we have the steel mill. And it's working. It should be somewhat halfway profitable. Not really. Okay. It's not profitable at all. We're losing money big time because of that. Okay, we really need to sell some iron. Yeah. So do we have to? Maybe the trade routes will expand that we have. Port max level, yeah, sure. Doesn't seem that way. No, doesn't seem that way. Okay, level. Let's go. Try and lose money less fast. So basically, after this, do motor industries use steel? They do. Okay, so get motor industries immediately after that, and then get railways as well. Yep. Sure. How are we looking on the time? Okay, I'll do a bit more. Let's at least try to, like, do the last steps. Let's try to get to railways. We should be able to get there. Peruvian-Bolivian Woman's Travels. A popular set of travel writings by a female author have been published, lending support to the propertied women law. She's traveled all over on her own. It is said she even rides her horse frontwards like a man. What a great boon for our cause. I'll roll the dice. You know what? Let the people know what they want. What they think of these travel writings. Well, they hated it. Yikes. Oh, now we have an iron shortage. That's not good. We can import a little from the Chileans. But we definitely need an iron mine. Like yesterday. Yesterday. How are these guys all looking in terms of peasants and infrastructure? Bad, bad, bad. All bad. Good. So you don't have any peasants. At least you have infrastructure, so I'm not sure if this is going to work, but I'll do it. I'll just do it anyway. So you actually need to go all the way to the front. Okay. Because we have a shortage of iron. Yes. No one else to trade with here. At least not to immediately fix that. Yikes. Why is this going down, actually? Ah, because you're not finding enough people. Ooh, and because of tools. Tools are expensive. Yikes. Yikes, 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 yikes. At least you're profitable. Could I spend a little more coal, a little more tools? Tools are already, like, super expensive, but at least this helps. Yeah, I'm trying to rush towards the first railway, but basically after that first railway, we'll really have to retool our economy. And we're going into debt again. That's not great. But I really want to get to railways. I just want to get to railways, make a cut there, and then try to actually make the economy healthy. Okay, we got the water tube boiler, which is good, but it also means more tools and coal, more tools and coal. So yeah. Not for now. Not for now. Basically, get the railway, and then we need to really get more resources so that we can actually afford to get more of those railways. So we're getting a motor industries now. Yeah, no, really. I always do just the extra neck on time. We have good legitimacy, so it's fine to take a little longer over each tick. Yeah, and we mostly care about it because of central banking. Which will also help us with the interest rate stuff. Motor Industries incoming. It's one of the it's not one of the most expensive buildings. Only 450 production. Like, it goes in, farms are 150. Some stuff are even cheaper, like barracks and the naval bases. Yes! There we have central banking, which is really going to help. Extra minting. Another 10%. Then, maybe... maybe nationalism? More authority? Could maybe do something for us. Let's go for it. While we have the intelligentsia happy, might as well use it. But yeah, that also helped amend our shortfall of... it helped at least be less in a deficit. Still do have a deficit, but it's fine. It's okay, and our GDP is growing. Industrial boom! See, our industry is growing. Textiles, Netafagasta are reporting paradox. Are reporting mills, plural. A small production surplus in industrial goods. We should look into investing this back in the state. Excuse me. I suppose we'll boost our industries. Newspapers offer support. Wait, what? The editor of the Peruvian Bolivia Gazette has come forward and offered to support the property to women law if we help them out with some funding. Yikes. I suppose we need to... I suppose the newspaper is going to write a good review of the travel writings, after all. In lieu of 1k government expenses. Ouch. But we're getting the railways! Yikes. Yeah, because Potosí is struggling. Okay, get me that railway. Get me that railway. Right now, it would give... Yeah, I'm fine with 15 infrastructure. Any unproductive trade routes? Nope. It's all fine. Importing... But I don't believe... Yeah, that can't be unproductive because it's literally the only silk I'm getting. You're wrong, game. Like, the game honestly shouldn't tell you that if you're dependent on import for a certain good. Yeah. Denmark agreed to become the what? Wait, what? Oh. Oh. Wait, what? Ah, shoot. Okay, let me address two things here. First of all, Denmark, the protectorate of Russia? What? Dude. Wow. Oh, Russia is on a roll, already incorporating Persia and what is the state again? Bukhara and all of Scandinavia in their market? Dude, Russia's on the move. But then we have this here. So this isn't great. Chile, who wants to be my friend, also wants to conquer the Tehuelche. I believe we have a defensive pact with them, right? Don't we? Yeah, an alliance even. Oof. Yikes. Oh yeah, because I count as the initiator, because so I wouldn't have been on this side if I weren't in a... man. I kind of want to, like, kick Chile Like I told you about Brazil, and I, playing as Brazil, I kicked Argentina way out of the of Patagonia and out of Paraguay. I kind of want to do that with Chile. It'll be tough. How much more for the 6 weeks? How much more here? Join my customs union for now. But probably I'll get pretty angry with you in a moment. Actually, Chile joining our market just created a shortage. A shortage of paper. So thanks, Chile, that did absolutely nothing for us. And now I want to attack you. Okay, let me just finish this railway, and then I'll make a cut. So 4 weeks, 3 weeks, 2 weeks. We should see a graphic as well, a graphic representation of the railway. Yes, look, it's glorious. Where's the train? Do we see a train yet? We do not. That's fine. So we have railroads in our country now, which means also that this, it has to. Okay, no, now I will make a cut here because I want to get in on this action. And I will also make a save because that could also go really badly. So thank you very much for watching. And the next episode will be good, will be exciting. So if you like this, then please leave a like, and comments are always appreciated, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.